minerals and energy resources. In last time we were discussing regarding as a conventional sources of energy, conventional sources of energy, those sources of energy which used by the humans from a longer historical background. So those number of resources of energy used by the humans from a long historical background to achieve their levels of their development are the, these are the conventional sources of, in which we were discussing regarding as a coal. Coal as a fossil fuel, there are four types of the coals which are generally has found on earth. Anthracite, bituminous, lignite and peat. Such differences, classification of a coal has based upon a carbon content. On the basis of a carbon content, the more carbon content means as a more energy emission, it will be as a occur. More energy will occur through the coal. Anthracite has the best quality of a coal, bituminous as a second, third as a lignite, and fourth peat, which consisting as a less than 40% of a coal, carbon content, sorry. In India, there are the two ages of a coal has extracted. One has a Gondwana age of coal, which has extracted to the Vardha Valley of Andhra Pradesh. Second one has a Kaveri Valley of Tamil Nadu. Third, Mahanadi Valley of Odisha, which is known through as a Talcher Mines, and Damodar Valley of West Bengal. Damodar Valley of West Bengal, Son Valley of Chhattisgarh. Then we discuss regarding as a tertiary age of coal. Then we discuss regarding as a petroleum. Petroleum extracted through as a crude oil. That crude oil which has extracted in a form of a drilling process of a mining. In India, there are a large number of the such reserves are there which are rich in a crude oil. Now we are in a natural gas. Third conventional sources of energy as a natural gas. Natural gas. So natural gas is associated with mostly with the oil deposits. Those areas where as the crude oil extracted, in such areas as the natural gas reserves are present. It is as one of the main sources of electricity, which directly contributes in a 10% of energy requirement, which completes a 10% of energy requirement in our country. 10% of energy requirement of our country completes to the natural gas. Completes to natural gas. Natural gas is a main industrial raw material in a petrochemical industries. Such industries which are known as a nodal industry. Remember, iron and steel industries are the basic industries. Mining is a killer industry, and petrochemical. Those industries which are based upon, which obtain their raw material from oil refineries. Such industries like as fertilizers, pharmaceuticals, cosmetics. These industries are the nodal industries, N-O-D-A-L. Nodal industries. Nodal industries. In India, the reserves of a natural gas are located in a Krishna Godavari basin of Andhra Pradesh. First, Krishna Godavari basin of Andhra Pradesh, Gulf of Cambay in Gujarat, Gulf of Cambay in Gujarat, Bombay High in Arabian Sea, Bombay High in Arabian Sea. In our country, natural gas is generally transporting through the pipeline transportation. India's longest pipeline transportation. India's longest pipeline, Hazira Vijaipur Jagdishpur. It's a 1700 kilometers long pipeline. Hazira in Gujarat. Hazira Vijaipur Jagdishpur. Vijaipur J Jagdishpur. Jagdishpur. HVJ, India's longest pipeline, gas pipeline, which has goes through the three of the states of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh. Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh. And Uttar Pradesh. Most number of the natural gas reserves, their reserves, their fields are located in offshore areas of Maharashtra to the western and the northern of India. The supplying of power to the supply of gas to the power, fertilizer and industrial complexes, they are the main users. HVJ pipeline has given a boost to the gas production in India. The gas supplied for household use as the LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, and CNG for automobiles. In automobiles, industrial purposes for which as the CNG has used. Compressed natural gas. So except these three, coal, petroleum, and natural gas, the fourth conventional sources of energy as a hydel power stations. They are also considered as a conventional sources of energy. These three, coal, petroleum, natural gas, are categorized under the non-renewable resources, except that the hydel power stations, hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity as the basic source of energy in our country at present. Hydroelectricity is generally produced by the force of a falling running water, which turns the turbine to convert into as the power. Hydel power is clean source, renewable, inexpensive, and a non-exhaustible and eco-friendly source of energy. Some of the multi-purpose river valley projects which were constructed in India after the independence, in this process as the first dam constructed after the independence was as the Bhakra Nangal Dam on a Satluj River. Bhakra Nangal, same as the other number of dams constructed for the purpose of a generation of a hydroelectricity. These as a Hirakud Dam on a Mahanadi, Sadasarovar Dam on a Narmada River, Tehri Dam on Ganga River, Tehri on Ganga, Nagarjuna Sagar on Krishna, and Tungabhadra on its tributary, Mettur in Kaveri. So these dams, such types of the dams, they constructed for a generation of electricity, for generation of a hydroelectricity in our country. Hydroelectricity in our country. Till there, any questions? These are of the conventional sources of energy: coal, petroleum, natural gas, and hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity. Coal also used in a thermal power stations for generation of electricity. Generation of electricity. In our state Punjab, there are the four thermal power stations are there. Earlier, the thermal power station of a Bhatan Tent in a underground. Yes, Bhumika.
सर एक बार डैम्स के नेम रिपीट कर दो.
भाखड़ा नंगल डैम ऑन सतलुज, भाखड़ा नंगल डैम ऑन सतलुज रिवर, हीराकुड डैम ऑन महानदी रिवर, सदा सरोवर ऑन नर्मदा, नागार्जुना सागर कृष्णा, मेटूर इन कावेरी, METTUR इन तमिलनाडु, कावेरी रिवर, एटसेट्रा. Next are non-conventional sources of energy. Non-conventional, such sources of energy, it's having as a potential for a growth of solar energy as per the location. Tropical conditions supportive for growth of solar energy in India. Photovoltaic technology has used for a photovoltaic technology used for transformation of insulation into the power, transformation of sunlight into the electricity. It is as specially in a rural areas. It's mostly as a popular in a rural areas or a smaller towns of Gujarat, Rajasthan, and Madhya Pradesh. India's largest solar panel located at the Bhagwanpur of Neemuch in Tamil Nadu. In Madhya Pradesh, Bhagwanpur. Bhagwanpur place, Neemuch as a district of Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, known for the India's largest solar panel. Other number of solar panels allocated as a Shirdi at the Bombay, third as a, at Bias in Punjab. Bias in Punjab, B-E-A-S, Bias in Punjab. Mostly as a solar energy used for a, it is used for a cooking, pumping water, heating water, and street lighting in our country. Street lightning in our country. Next, as source of energy, as a tidal energy. India having as a potential. India having as a vast potential for a growth of a tidal energy because of its long coastal line from Gujarat towards West Bengal. Akhilesh, raise your hand. Rule number one, if you are there, raise your hand. Okay. Yes, Akhilesh. Can you tell me about the total length of a coastline of India? Yes, Akhilesh. Length of coastline of India. Akhilesh. Okay, next one has a 9 roll number. Who's a 9? Raise your hand. 9 roll number. 9. Eighteen roll number. 27. All these roll numbers are absent. 9, I think it will be as a Ekjot. Keshav, 18 roll number. Yes. Keshav, yes, answer. What's the length of India's coastline from Gujarat, the coast of Gujarat towards West Bengal? Keshav Kalra.
Yes, sir.
Answer. Should I repeat again question?
Sir. 7,000 something.
Sorry? Repeat it.
Sir, it's near about 7,000 kilometers something.
Okay, very good. 7516.6 kilometers long coastline from Gujarat. That coastline shared from a Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, and West Bengal. So such longer coastline supportive for a growth of a tidal energy in India, but it has categorized under the potential because of the other sources of energy are widely used in our country, like as a thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, hydroelectricity, solar panels. That's why there's a less emphasis over the tidal energy in India. But there is as a one place in India where which is known for the growth of a tidal energy, where as the 900 megawatt every year, such electricity as a produce. It is located at the Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat. Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat, where as India's tidal energy has produced. Tidal energy. In a tidal energy, oceanic tides. Tides are caused due to the gravitational pull of sun and moon. Sun and moon at the time of the high tides. If a turbine is located at the coastal regions, that rising water, when it will be strike over the turbines, through which as we can generate, with the rotation of a turbines, we can generate as electricity. We can generate the electricity. Initial cost of installation of such kind of turbines, it will be as a high. But when we are talking about a longer duration of time, when we compare the tidal energy with the other sources of energy, thermal power stations, which needs as a setup as an industry and needs as raw material. Coal also required as a timely through the burning of a coal, electricity generates. So when we compare the thermal power stations, nuclear power stations with the tidal energy, it will be as a more cheaper. Once the allocating the turbines in a coastal regions, it will be as a supportive for generation of electricity. The floodgates of a dams, which will be as a built across in a inlets during as a high tides, water flows into the inlets and gets trapped. When the gate is closed, after the tide falls outside the floodgate, the water restrained by the floodgate flows back to the sea via a pipe that carries it to a power generating turbines. With rotation of a turbines, we can generate as electricity. It is as an eco-friendly source of energy. Eco-friendly, but still as a, it categorized under the potential sources. In near in future, after 10, 20, 50 years, their use, it will be as a start in our country. Second source of energy as a tidal energy, clear? Third as a wind energy. Till there, any questions? Third as the wind energy. Wind energy. Next is the wind energy. So India has also vast potential for a growth of wind energy. The potential states for producing wind energy in India are the Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Lakshadweep, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has the largest wind farm cluster located at a Nagarkoil place. Nagarkoil in Tamil Nadu. India's largest wind energy plant located at the Nagarkoil near Madurai, and accept this as the Jaisalmer also. Another well-known place is Jaisalmer in Rajasthan. It is fulfilling the requirement of a local power for domestic and agricultural purposes. Growth of wind energy also supportive in areas of coastal regions where tropical cyclones, the eastern coastal plains, tropical cyclones supportive for growth of wind energy. As you learned in your previous classes, India has experienced a monsoonal climate. Monsoons during the months of June, July, August, September, afterwards as a retreating monsoon winds, September, October, November, they are supportive for a rotation of windmills through which we can generate as electricity in a desertic parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat, and in the other side as a coastal regions through which we can generate as electricity. We can generate as the eco-friendly form of electricity, which will be considered one of the cheapest modes of generation of electricity for longer duration of time. In relation to the longer duration of time, wind energy, tidal energy, these non-conventional sources of energy are considered as the cheapest comparatively the thermal and nuclear power stations. Next, as a geothermal energy, it refers to the heat and electricity produced by using the heat from the interior of the earth. Underground water in active volcanic regions gets heated in contact with the heated rocks. Steam pressure builds and rises to Earth's surface. This steam energy can be converted into the electricity. Hot springs in India can be used for generating the electricity. So at present, there are the two experimental projects are going on. First, in a Parvati Valley near the Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh. And second one in a Puga Valley of Ladakh. Puga Valley in Ladakh in Jammu and Kashmir, associated with the generation of electricity through the internal heat of the earth. When generally as epicenters are located on epicenters, warm water geysers, they emit on a surface of the earth crust. Such areas are supportive for the growth of geothermal energy, which is also one of the cheapest modes of energy generation in a longer duration of time. Next, as a biogas plants, biogas, farm waste, human waste, and animal waste are used for producing the biogas for domestic purposes. Biogas for the domestic purposes in our country. Biogas used for domestic purposes in our country. Generally, as a such kind of materials used in rural areas, decomposition of organic matter yields the gas with more thermal efficiency than kerosene, charcoal, and other forms of energy. Biogas plants can be set up at a cooperative and individual levels, especially in rural areas, as gober gas plants. So gober gas plants exclusively using cow dung in rural areas for production of gas. After the production of a gas, the remain which has released from such biogas plants, it can be used as a manure in agriculture fields, which is supportive for the organic farming. It is supportive for the organic farming. Except these five means of non-conventional sources of energy: tidal energy, solar energy, geothermal energy, wind energy, and biogas. One more is there, which is as increasing or completing our energy requirement. That is the nuclear power stations. Nuclear power stations are also supportive for the generation of electricity in our country. Nuclear energy is produced from the uranium and thorium substances. All over the world, there are the 27,000 tons of total such nuclear substances are available. In nuclear reactors, through the process of fission and fusion, such atoms are used for generation of atomic energy. Uranium and thorium are available in Jharkhand and Aravali Hills of Rajasthan. Uranium found in Jharkhand and Aravali ranges of Rajasthan, and whereas thorium, it can easily extract it to the monazite rocks of Kerala. Monazite sands of Kerala. Presently, the contribution of nuclear energy is very small, which will definitely rise in future, keeping in mind the increasing levels of energy consumption. Thorium, which has found in Kerala, it has categorized under the reserves, because presently we are completing our 80% of uranium and thorium consumption that need directly from the United States of America. We are importing our nuclear fuel from US towards our country, because the present nuclear fuel in our country is very limited, which may be as a vanish after the 30 to the 50 years. So for continuation of a growth of energy and regularization of a sustainable development, for which as we are saving the such nuclear fuels of thorium in Kerala for future. We are saving for the future. Presently, there are the six nuclear power stations. First, as a Tarapur in Maharashtra, Narora in Uttar Pradesh, Tarapur in Maharashtra. Tarapur in Maharashtra. Maharashtra. Narura, Uttar Pradesh. Narura, Uttar Pradesh. Narura, Uttar Pradesh. Rawat Bhata, Rajasthan. Rawat Bhata in Rajasthan. Kaiga, K-A-I-G-A. Kaiga in Karnataka. Kaiga in Karnataka. Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu. Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu. Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu. Kakrapara in Gujarat. Kakrapara in Gujarat. Kakrapara in Gujarat. So these six nuclear power stations are well known in our country, which has completing our 40% of energy requirement. Tarapur in Maharashtra, Narura in Uttar Pradesh, Kaiga in Karnataka, Rawat Bhata in Rajasthan, Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu, Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu, and Kakrapara in Gujarat. Kakrapara in Gujarat. These places are associated with the nuclear power stations where the use of a uranium and thorium used for a atomic energy, nuclear energy, used for a nuclear energy in our country. Clear? So till there, any questions? Any questions? This chapter, it will be not assessed in a board examinations. It will be the ask in a pre-chapter. From this chapter, only as a map content will ask in a board examinations for identification. Mines, it will be as a located on a map and associated with the such places. Hints will mark in a question paper. You have to identify such places. So last topic of this chapter as a conservation of energy resources. Conservation of energy resources. Energy requirement of our country is constantly increasing. It is due to the modernization, urbanization, and ever improving sectors of economy. Agriculture, industry, transport, and commercial purposes for which as the increasing day by day. So energy development and production is not able to keep pace with the rising consumption pattern. So we have to adopt a cautious approach for the judicious use of our limited number of sources of energy. Like as we have to check upon the equipments regularly. Second, we have to check the wastage of such number of sources of energy at that time of the extraction, when the coal has extracted, when coal has used in a thermal power stations processing and their usage and their consumption. At such stages, we have to check their wastage, minimize their wastage. We must use our limited energy resources in a judicious and planned manner. We have to increase the use of a non-conventional sources of energy as compared to conventional sources of energy. We must try to use more of public transport system and less of individual vehicles. We have to emphasize on a greater use of a non-conventional, comparatively the conventional sources of energy, because everyone must keep in mind that the energy saved is energy produced in our country. That's why at the beginning of a chapter, we discussed that resources, they play as an indispensable role in human growth. Indispensable role in human growth because the without the use of such minerals and sources of energy development, it can't be as a possible for regularization, regular sustainable growth of our economy. We need as such minerals, energy minerals and other minerals throughout the time. So for which as a regular use of such minerals, it can be as a possible when we will emphasize over their conservation to the minimizing the wastage. This was our chapter, minerals and energy resources. Any questions? Minerals and energy resources. Any questions? Yes, any questions? So now the next has the exercise, question answers. Question answers. Which one of the following minerals is formed by the decomposition of a rocks leaving a residual mass of a weathered material? It's a bauxite. Bauxite. Second, Koderma in a Jharkhand is a leading producer of which one of the following minerals? Mica. Second B, minerals are deposited and accumulated in the stratas of which of the following rocks? Deposited and accumulated in the stratas as a sedimentary. And which one of the following minerals is contained as a monazite sand? Thorium. You have to attempt only as a second part. Answer the questions briefly. Answer the questions briefly on your notebooks. Answer the questions briefly on your notebooks. Tomorrow we will start as a manufacturing industries.